Good morning, students. In my previous video, I told you how to calculate goodwill by simple average profit method. Today, we will discuss about how to calculate goodwill by weighted average profit method. Before that, I'll solve question number 13. Look at the screen. Question number 13 is, Geet and Meet are partners in a firm. They admit Geet into partnership for equal share. It was agreed that goodwill will be valued at 3 years purchase of average profit of last 5 years. Profits for the last 5 years is given in the question. Books of account of the firm revealed that first point is the firm had gained profit of ₹50,000 from sale of machinery sold in the year ended 31st March 2017. The gain was credited in the P&L account. Second point is there was an abnormal loss of ₹20,000 incurred in the year ended 31st March 2018 because of a machine becoming obsolete in accident. Third point is overhauling cost of second-hand machinery purchased on 1st of July 2018 amounting to ₹1 lakh was debited to repairs account. Depreciation in charge at the rate of 20% per annum of written down value method. Calculate the value of goodwill. First of all, you will write year ended. First column is year ended. You will write the date. 31st of March 2016, 31st March 2017, 31st March 2018, 31st March 2019, and last only 31st March 2020. After that, we will write profits. Given the question, profits 90,000. It is loss. You can write in bracket. After that, 1,60,000 in 2017, 1,50,000 in 2018, and 65,000 in 2019 and last one, 1,77,000 in 2020. After that, we will make a column of adjustment. After that, you will read the adjustment given the question. First is the firm had gained 50,000. It is abnormal gain. So you have to deduct from the year 31st March 2017. It is 50,000. Second point is there was an abnormal loss of ₹20,000 incurred in the year ended 31st March 18. It is an abnormal loss. You have to add this amount 20,000 in 2018. 20,000. After that, last adjustment is overhauling cost of second-hand machinery purchased on 1st of July 2018 amounting to 1 lakh was debited to repairs account. You have to add 1 lakh in 2019, 1 lakh. It is a capital expenditure, not revenue expenditure. So we have to add 1 lakh and minus depreciation. We have to calculate depreciation 20% of this value. 20% of 1 lakh is 20,000 for 9 months. 9 by 12, this is the 9, 3, 4, 12, 4, 5, 20. It is 15,000. We have to less 15,000. In last year, after reduction of depreciation, you will get 85,000 balance of the machine. And you will calculate depreciation 20% because written down value method is given in the question. It is 17,000. So you have to deduct 17,000. After that, you will make a column normal profit. Normal profits. There is no adjustment in 16. You will write
90,000 loss. After that, you have to deduct 50,000 from 1,60,000. You will get 1,10,000. So 1,50,000 plus 20,000. It is 1,70,000. 65,000 plus 1 lakh, that is 1,65,000 minus 15,000. 165 minus 15. It is 1,50,000. And in the last 1,77,000, deduct 17,000, you get 1,60,000 only. After that, you will add all the figures. One sixty, one fifty, one seventy, one ten, zero. Six lakh minus 90,000. 6 lakh minus 90,000, you get 5,10,000. 160, 150, 170, 110. It is 590 minus 90, it is 5 lakh only. After that, you will apply that formula. Average profit is equal to total profit. We can write total normal profits also, divided by number of years. Total profit is 5 lakh divided by 5, and you will get 1 lakh average profit. After that, you will calculate goodwill. Goodwill is equal to average profit into number of years purchased. Average profit is 1 lakh. And number of years purchase is given the question, that is 3 years purchase. You have to multiply by 3 and you will get answer. Answer is 3 lakh. After that, I am telling you question number 14, that is from weighted average profit method. Weighted average profit method. Average profit is equal to total weighted profit divided by total of weight. And after that, for goodwill, weighted average profit method, weighted average profit into number of years purchased. Question number 14 is, profit of a firm for the year ended 31st March for the last 5 years. Profit is given. You will write profits. First of all, you have to write the year ended. March 31st, 2016, 17, 18, 19, and last 20. 31st of March
Then you write profit. Profit is 20,000 in 2016, 24,000 in 17, 30,000 in 18, 25,000 in 19, and 18,000 in 20.
After that, we have to assign weights to each and every year.
Weight 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And last column is weighted profit. For weighted profit, you have to multiply by the A column, B, C, D. D is equal to B into C. It is 20,000, 48,000, 90,000, 1 lakh. What is 90,000? You will add all the figures. It is 3,48,000, and you have to add rate also. 5, 4, 9, 3, 12, 14, and 15. Now you will apply formula. Weighted average profit method is equal to total weighted profit is 3,48,000 divided by rate 15 to 30 and 4, 15 to 45, 23,200. And for goodwill, 2300 into
number of years purchased is given in the question. 3 years.
You have to multiply by 3 and you will get 3,900. 69,600.
Now the second method is super profit method.
Super profit method. This is the second method to calculate goodwill.
Super profit method is equal to
actual average profit minus normal profit. And for calculation of goodwill, goodwill is equal to super profit into number of years purchased.
You have to calculate normal profit. Actual or average profit is given the question, but you have to calculate normal profit. For
normal profit is equal to capital employed. Capital employed into NRR, normal rate of return, divided by 100.
What is capital employed? Capital employed is the capital invested by the partners in the business. You can calculate capital employed. There are two methods. There are two approaches. First one is liabilities approach. According to this approach,
capital employed is equal to capital plus reserve minus goodwill if any appear in the balance sheet already. So minus fictitious assets minus non trade investment. Second approach is assets approach. Assets according to assets approach, capital employed is equal to all assets minus goodwill if any appear already in the balance sheet minus fictitious assets minus outside liabilities. With the help of two approaches we can calculate a capital employed. Now I am solving a question of super profit method. Question number 19. The total capital of the firm of Sakshi, Mehak and Mega is 1 lakh and the market rate of interest is 15%. The net profit for the last 3 years were 30,000, 36,000 and 42,000. Goodwill is to be valued at 2 years purchase of the last 3 years of the profit. Calculate the goodwill of the firm. You know, super profit is equal to average profit minus normal profit. I have told you already how to calculate average profit. In this question, 3 years profit is given 30,000. Average profit is equal to 36 plus 42 divided by 3. 66 or 42. It is more like 8,000 divided by 3. It is 36,000. Average profit is equal to 36,000 minus normal profit. For normal profit, normal profit is equal to capital employed into NRR. Normal rate of return, or we can say market rate of interest, divided by 100. Capital is given in the question, 1 lakh. Normal rate of return is given, 15%, divided by 100. It is 15,000. Normal profit is 15,000. You have to deduct 15,000 from 36,000 and you will get 21,000. 36 or 15? 21, right. 21,000 is the super profit. Or for goodwill, super profit into number of years consumed. Super profit is 21,000 and the number of years purchase is given in the question, that is
2 years purchase. You have to multiply by 2
for goodwill. 21,000 into 2, it is 42,000. It is the answer.
Thank you.